Trailblazers, welcome to church. It's another Sunday. I'm so excited to see you guys. I've missed you so much. It's been months and months and months. How have you been? I'm sure you've been good boys and girls, and I'm sure mommy and daddy are very happy with you. I'm so happy to see you here. It's been a long time, and I promise you today is gonna be a very wonderful day. We have a lot of exciting things planned for today. We'll have a prayer, we'll do our praise and worship, and our praise and worship, we have some dance steps that I want you guys to, you know, to dance to and practice, so that when we come back to church, you will show me your dance steps. And then after our worship, we'll go to our lesson for the day. Before that, we'll do a recap of what Auntie Tina taught us last week. So before we proceed, can we close our eyes and say a word of prayer? Our Father and our God, we thank you for today. Thank you for yet another Sunday in your presence. We give you praise because we know we're going to have fun today. We thank you because you are bringing us your word afresh. And as we study at your feet, thank you because we will leave your presence with better for it in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask, O God, that Lord, you will make this week a special week for us. We ask, O God, you continue to help us by the help of your Holy Spirit to be good boys and girls for our parents and for you, our God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Wasn't that fun? It's so much fun to pray and to talk to God. You know why? Because God talks back to us, and God is always, always excited to hear from us. It's such a good thing to talk to God, to communicate with him, and then to pray to him and then hear him talk back to us. So now it's time for us to worship God, to thank him for all that he has been doing for us, to praise his name. So right now we're going to go and watch a worship video. Put on your dancing shoes. There's a dance step in the video, so I need you to watch closely and practice, because when we come back to church, you are going to show me your dance moves. So I'll see you after the video. Bye. Jesus, that's you. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's you. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's you.
Count on Jesus. I can always count. friends, help me listen for Shine.
Wee! Did you find the answer to the question? What problems are too big for God?
Yep.
Welcome back, Trailblazers. Wasn't that fun? Oh my word. I danced. It was so much fun. So, let's get into our lesson proper. Who can tell me what we learned last week? Who remembers? Yes? Alfred, I see you raising your hand. Do you want to tell me what we learned last week? Yeah? Awesome sauce, that's correct. Last week, we learned about the big picnic. And does anybody want to tell me what the big picnic was all about? Good job. Yes, the big picnic was about Jesus Christ and how he fed 5,000 people with just 2 fishes and 5 loaves of bread. Wow, isn't that awesome? Because nothing is impossible for God to do. And then that takes us to our memory verse from last week. So what did Auntie Tina tell us last week was our memory verse? Anybody want to try? I know it. Does anyone want to try? Oh, you want us to say it together? Okay, let's go ahead. We all say it together. So our memory verse from last week was taken from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 32, verse 17. And it says, O Lord, you made the heaven and the earth, and nothing is too hard for you to do. Good job. Clap for yourself. Oh, rather, roll it for yourself. Roll it, and let it go. I am a trailblazer. Good job. So, what are we learning this week? This week, our topic is a test in the desert. Yes, a test in the desert. So I'm wondering, what kind of test? Is it math test? Is it an English test? Do you like to take tests? I know taking tests can be a bit tricky, but then you know something? When you take your test, at the end of the test, you are the better for it. Okay, enough of me talking. So let's go watch the video this week. Let's see the kind of test Emily has got for us. And then, after the video, I'll see you. Bye for now.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Friends, I'm happy to see you. I'm going on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to go with me. Woohoo! Who is it? Come in!
Wee! Hiya, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Shine, what should we find out on our Bible adventure?
Let's find the answer to the question, what do you say to sins?
sins? You mean wrong choices? I do want to know what I should say when I think I want to sin.
Well, I know which picture passes will help you find the answer.
Friends, put on your adventure bags! Now we can be picture pass guessers together!
Here's your first clue. You wash with it to get nice and clean.
Friends, which one is it? You're right! It is the soap! Catch the soap in your adventure bag! Shine, what's next?
This picture pass is icky and sticky. It makes you get all dirty.
Ew! Friends, which one is it? You're right! It is the mud! Catch the mud, the icky, sticky mud, in your adventure bag.
Now there's only one picture pass left, but it's a fun one.
What is it?
You yell into it to make your voice really loud.
Friends, which one do you think it is? You are great guessers! It is the megaphone. Catch the megaphone in your adventure bag. Friends, count with me. One, two, three. They're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bag together. Now it's time to fly!
Whoa!
Whoa! Shine, picking those picture passes was fun, but talking about sin and wrong choices isn't.
You're right. Sin is always bad.
Well, how do I find the answer to the question? What do you say to sins?
When I need help finding answers, I look in the Bible.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
A test in the desert. Hey, that story's from the book of Matthew in the Bible.
Let's hope it shows us what we should say to sins. Let's find out.
God's Spirit led Jesus into the desert. He had nothing to eat for 40 days and nights. After that, Jesus was very hungry. Knowing that Jesus was hungry, the devil tempted him. He pointed to a rock and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these rocks to become bread." Jesus answered the devil using God's words from the Bible. "It's not just bread that keeps people alive," he said. "Their lives also depend on what God says." Next, the devil took Jesus to the top of the temple. "If you are the Son of God, jump off. The scriptures say that God's angels will rescue you." So Jesus used God's word to give his second answer. "Do not put the Lord your God to the test," he said, quoting again from the Bible. Finally, the devil took Jesus to a mountain and showed him all the world's kingdoms and wealth. "This can be yours," he said, "if you bow down and worship me." "Go away, Satan," Jesus commanded. Then he quoted God's word one more time. "For it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only." As soon as Jesus said it, the devil left him. Then angels came and cared for him. Jesus had faced temptation and hadn't sinned, not even once.
Rizzlin' razzles! The devil wanted Jesus to sin.
But Jesus was God's son, so he always said no to sins.
I think I know the answer now. Shine, ask me the question.
What do you say to sins?
I say no to sins.
Wait, that's the answer. I bet Guy, the Bible guy, knows a Bible verse about that.
Oh, I bet you're right. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Friends, let's go.
Emily?
We just learned that Jesus always said no to sins.
Oh, that's right. He never made a wrong choice because he's God's son. He stayed pure.
Pure? What's that mean?
Pure means clean. Jesus' heart stayed clean from sin.
Jesus didn't even have one wrong choice in his heart?
He sure didn't. Do you have a picture pass about that?
I think I do! Friends, which picture pass do you wash with to get nice and clean? Friends, you got it! It is the soap! We wash with soap to get clean on the outside.
And Jesus is like super soap to wash you pure and clean on the inside. He takes sin and wrong choices right out of your heart.
How do I know if he's washed my heart to be pure and clean?
Have you asked Jesus to be your leader and your best friend?
You know I have.
Then he has washed you pure and clean on the inside. I know a Bible verse about that. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to say the verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Looks like you're all ready. Listen to this. Psalm 51:10. God, create a pure heart. Ba-bum, ba-bum. In me.
I like it. Friends, say it with me this time.
Okay, here we go. Psalm 51:10.
Psalm 51:10.
God.
God.
Create a pure heart. Ba-bum, ba-bum.
Create a pure heart. Ba-bum, ba-bum.
In me.
In me.
Great job. Now let's try it all together.
Psalm 51:10. God,
create a pure heart.
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
In me. That's it. After God washes sin and wrong choices out of your heart, what do you say to sin?
I say no to sins, just like Jesus. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily.
Come on.
Bye, friends.
Hi. Welcome back. Wasn't that fun? Yes, it was. And I learned a lot. Actually, I learned it was more serious than a math test or an English test. So, who can tell me what the test was about? Yes? Whoa! About 6 people already raising their hands. Efosa, I see you. Mafeng, I see you. Alfred, Isaac. Oh, you too, Israel. And Damilola. Oh, wow. You guys are so smart. Okay, so tell me what the test was all about. Awesome sauce. Yes, it was no math test or English test. It was about the devil wanting Jesus to do bad things. Oh boy, that is not good. So who can tell me what the devil was trying to get Jesus to do? Good job. So, the devil was trying to get Jesus to turn stone into bread. Secondly, he wanted Jesus to jump from one tall building so that the angels could catch him. And third, what the nerve! He wanted Jesus Christ to bow down and worship him. Oh my word, that is so bad. Yeah, pretty bad. That is a very huge test. But I'm so happy. Do you know why I'm happy? Because Jesus did not do anything that the devil wanted him to do. What did you say? What? You think it was because Jesus couldn't do it? Of course, Jesus could do it. But Jesus chose not to do it because it was not the right thing to do. So then, what did Jesus do? Jesus did what? Yeah, of course, Jesus said something. What did Jesus say? Good job! Jesus said no. Jesus said no to the devil. It wasn't just Jesus saying no to the devil, you know. It was Jesus saying no to what? Jesus was saying no to sin. So, do you want to tell me what you understand about sin? What do you think sin means? Oh, you would like me to tell you? Gladly, I'll tell you. So, sin is anything that makes us to live in disobedience to God. Sin is anything that makes us walk in opposite direction of what God wants us to do. And God does not want us to listen to the devil so that we can disobey him. God wants us to say no to sin every time. You want me to explain further? Well, sure, I will. So, sin is anything that makes you make the wrong choice. Say, mommy tells you to do something, and then you go and do the opposite. That is sin against mom. In the same way, God tells us to do some things. If we go against what God has told us to do, then we are sinning against God. Or if we do something that God says we should not do, then we are sinning against God. And it's not good to do that. So every time we have a test to say or do things that God does not want to do, what are we supposed to say? Say that again. Again. Awesome sauce. Yes, we say no to sin. We say no to wrong choices. We say no to when the devil is whispering in our ears and telling us to do things that we are not supposed to do. Yes, you guys have been so awesome. So, I want you to roll it for yourself one more time. Here goes. Roll it, and let it go. I am a trailblazer. Awesome. So, I know that we may be wondering, how can I say no to sin? Can anyone tell me how Jesus said no to sin? Yeah? Oh, I'm so proud of you. It means you were paying attention when you were watching the video. Of course, Jesus was able to say no to the devil and, of course, no to sin because Jesus knew the word of God. You know, we've been learning about the Bible for some time now. Yes, so Jesus learned about the Bible and then he hid the word of God in his heart. That's how Jesus was able to say no to sin. That's how Jesus was able to say no to the devil. Yes, when you have the word of God in your heart, yes, it's so easy to say no to sin. But it's not always easy to say no to sin with the word of God in your heart, because there has to be something that puts the word of God in your heart in the first instance. Can anybody tell me? Oh, you don't know? Really? You don't know what will keep the word of God in your heart? Oh, I know, because I've been practicing for a long time. Okay? It's when you ask Jesus into your heart. And when you ask Jesus into your heart, he cleans your heart. He washes your heart with his blood. And then your heart is spanking new. Remember when I told you in the beginning that it's fun to talk to God? Yes, when Jesus cleans your heart and washes it with his blood, it makes it easy for you to talk to God. And then when you want to make a wrong decision, you can ask Jesus to help you with the word of God that you have put in your heart. And then it will be easy for you to say no to sin. It will be easy for you to tell the devil, stay over there. I don't want you near me. Do not come near me. I say no to you. Yes. Today has been awesome, hasn't it? I told you it was going to be a fun day. And I really had fun because as I was talking to you, I was learning by myself. That was an awesome class. I had fun because I learned a lot. And now it's time for us to learn the memory verse for the week. So, were you able to pick the memory verse from when Emily was showing you the video? No, you didn't? Oh, you've been doing so well anyway, but don't worry, I'm glad to tell you. So, the memory verse for today was taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 51, verse 10, and it says, O God, create a pure heart in me. Did you get that? Oh, I should say it one more time. No problem. O God, create a pure heart in me. Oh, you got it this time. Come on, let's say it together. Psalm 51, verse 10, and it says, O God, create a pure heart in me. Awesome, you did great. I'm going to ask you next week, and you should be able to tell me. So, during the week, I want you to practice and practice and practice and say Psalm 51, verse 10. O God, create a pure heart in me. All right. Before we go, I want us to do an activity. We've been talking about a pure heart, and we talked also that we can only have a pure heart when Jesus is in our heart and he helps us to keep the word of God in our heart. So, my activity for today, we're going to be drawing our heart that has been made pure by Jesus Christ. And then, we're going to write the Bible inside of it to show that we are keeping the word of God in our heart. You are such awesome children, and I'm so proud to be having this Sunday service with you. So come on, let's draw our hearts. So I'm drawing the hearts. This is my own heart that Jesus Christ has made pure with his precious, precious blood that he shed for me on the cross of Calvary. Isn't my heart beautiful? I'm sure your heart is beautiful as well. And then, because Jesus Christ has washed my heart pure, he has helped me to hide the word in my heart, I'm going to write the Bible in the middle of my heart. Here we go. And the Bible is spelled B-I-B-L-E. There you go. Do you like that? Okay, you can take it a step further by coloring the heart. Okay, because the blood of Jesus has made my heart clean, I'm going to color my heart red to show the blood of Jesus really did an awesome job on my heart. So there goes my heart with the pure red blood of Jesus. There you go. There you go. I know you're going to do it more awesome job than me, but it's all right. And then when church opens, you can actually bring your heart to church. I would love to see what you did. And then I'm going to color my Bible. I think I'm going to use color green. You can use whatever color you like, but I'm going to use color green. There you go. There you go. So you can tell mommy to help you to draw if you can't draw. Mommy can help you to draw and show you how to draw. Or you can tell daddy. Either of them can help you to draw, but be sure to color it in by yourself. And when you come back to church, I want you to show me. So this is mine. Isn't it awesome? Right. Okay, so that is all we have for this week. I'll be back with you next week. And then I want you to be able to say your memory verse by heart, okay? I want you to be able to say your memory verse and be able to tell me a summary of what we have done today. So let me quickly go over it for you. So today we said we should learn to say no to sin, no to wrong choices, no to things that are bad, that are disobedience to God and to our parents. And we also said that we cannot say no by ourselves. We can only say no when we have the Word of God in our heart. And we also said that the only way we can have the Word of God in our heart is when we have invited Jesus Christ into our hearts to wash our hearts clean and make it pure. And then the Word of God can reside in our hearts. Awesome class, guys. I enjoyed spending today with you. Today was an awesome Sunday, don't you think? It was. Okay, I'll see you next week. Be good boys and girls and take care of yourself. I love you. Bye.